5K. Take 3. Okay, so here's the thing. It happened. We've turned that 5,000 subs corner, and now that I'm famous, we all know it's straight downhill from here. The drugs, the booze, the sex scandals, the paranoia, then the overdose in an obscure hotel in Paris, and finally the posthumous cult worship. But while I'm still lucid, let's talk about some YouTubing type people. These aren't all shoutouts. Some of these people don't need shoutouts. Some of them don't produce video content, really. Today I'm talking about some people I watch, some people I respect, some people I want to thank, some I'm calling them out because they owe me money. Almost all of them I hope to have something sarcastic to say about. Warning, I think a couple of these people hate each other's guts. But that's the great thing about having your own channel. You can watch anyone you damn well want. And don't worry, they're all gonna patch things up at the next conference and ask each other back to their rooms for coffee. Hey, one more thing. There are so many people I wanted to mention in this video that it would last forever if I talked about all of them. In order to get this thing off the ground, there are some YouTubers I want to recognize just as much. I just didn't have time to snark about them. So I'm going to list them on screen at the end. Please check them out. I beg of you. Okay, now going in alphabetical order, Anacontavod. He's a badass. By virtue of his ability to withstand any negative comments people might leave on his videos, he's not offended by anyone. He considers Inmendum a fascinating case study. Also because he can withstand extreme negative temperatures. Andy, he goes for walks in 20 below weather because it feels good. This is the guy who climbed Everest in short sleeves. He invented Kelvin because Fahrenheit and Celsius weren't cold enough. He was invited to join the Polar Bear Club for their annual icy plunge, but he thought, what's the point? Arguing from ignorance. He's the sheep guy. He's new, but he's exploding out of the UK area. He puts across and debunks arguments in a visual style and reminds me a little of Qualia soup. I find it rude that people from the US are always lumping the British, Irish, Welsh, Scottish, and even the Australians into a single general accent. They just assume they're all from over there somewhere. So I found a big list of town names for Britain and Ireland and such on this website, and I'm gonna do my best to guess where I think they're all from based on their regional dialect. And arguing from ignorance is from Balls Cross, West Sussex. Maybe. Moving on. Bod Bits. He was Bod Two Bits, but he had the two surgically removed in a risky and embarrassing operation. There is a scar, but please don't mention it to him. Look, he's required viewing. He will be on the exam, and he counts for a significant portion of your grade. Study him. But good luck, he's a very mysterious man. No one knows much about him. That being said, I wouldn't be surprised to hear that he was the leader of the resistance in some really interesting thing like that Falkland Islands gig back in the 80s. Anyway, he exudes intrigue, and he could probably kill you with a rolled-up magazine, Jason Bourne style, if he wanted to. Oh, Bod is from Bitchfield, Lincolnshire, it sounds like. I don't know. Benjamin Smythe. People PM him their life issues, and he breaks them down with a remarkable fluidity and articulation. He's like Alan Watts, if Alan Watts had a hipper vocabulary and was an obsessive skateboarder. There's no pretense, no woo, and no editing. Ben's the kind of guy who'll get a knock on the door in the middle of a video and say, yeah, hold on, I have to go get a pizza, and then be gone for 5 minutes while he's talking to the delivery guy and come back and pick up where he left off. He doesn't give a crap about it. And he just let everyone know that he's not going to make any more videos. Watch his old stuff while you can. Capricious Black Box. He's the best auto mechanic west of Winnipeg. He is such a nice, warm guy. He's so warm that no snow can accumulate within 100 yards of his house. Certainly nowhere near his hot tub, where he bubbles up ideas for some of his best videos. He's the kind of great, warm, open, diplomatic, nice-hearted guy that if he hated you, you'd wish other people would love you that much. Captain Andy. He addresses and responds to issues in a conversational way. Just a good and earnest guy who speaks well and isn't afraid to disagree. And I'm speculating, but I think he's probably immune to alcohol, like most of the British, and would likely drink us all under the table. By his accent, I think Andy's from Wambottom Lane, Lancashire. Cheeky Vimto 08. Man, is he easy to listen to. Great voice, and he knows his stuff. Philosopher, composer, pianist, Renaissance man. He is also one of the curators over at the Atheist Hub channel. Finally, a great guy who's been very supportive and who comes from Shittington, Bedfordshire. I'm not making this up. Okay, it's possible he's not from there, but I am not making up the name of this town. It's legit. Conference report. The Duke of Cornwall, the Rabbit Whisperer, Professor Prolific. He's posted more videos than the porn industry. He's a fixture here and has earned his respect as a thoughtful man of integrity. And it sounds like to me Fred grew up in Scratchy Bottom, Dorset. Cool Hard Logic. You know who he is. He's the guy who stabs geocentrists in the heart with Kepler's Law of Planetary Motion, and then stands victorious over their bloody corpses. Plus, he's the guy who invented silent bubble wrap. No, not really, but guessing from his accent, I think he does live on Turkey Cock Lane in Colchester, Essex. Corey Anton, the YouTuber formerly known as Professor Anton. I've watched almost all his old videos, and I've come to the conclusion that sometimes I can't understand what the hell the professor is talking about. Half of me is trying to absorb what I can, and the other half is thinking that there must be people out there who understand all of it. He and those people are smarter than I am, but I enjoy listening. Dehi Dublin, cool dude, modern gentleman, and the very unofficial Prime Minister of Ireland, and the guy who taught me that Ireland is not part of the UK. For real. Plus, he's one of the four horsemen of the comments section. We'll come back to that. Dehi is from Duty's Bottoms in County Wicklow. Maybe. Possibly. Dark Viper 888. 8? Is there a fourth 8? I can't remember. He's one of the most self-deprecating YouTubers in the skeptical community. Basically, if he starts off with, "I'm sorry if this video is so terrible, I know I'm gonna like it." Right now, he's taking apart the Quran from a decidedly what-the-fuck perspective. And his room is always so clean. If I had a room in my apartment that clean, I'd shoot on-camera videos too. Oh yeah, Wet Wang in Yorkshire. Dazzle Tag. A man with a thousand faces, master of dry British satire and wit. His characters remind me of the show Little Britain. I'd say he should get around to making more videos, but I can think of a couple of people who would immediately show up in my comment box to remind me just how infrequently I finish my own. Dazzletag resides in Ramsbottom, Lancashire. Or he could, he might. Deep Ashtray. He's Sam Elliott incarnate. He's the Marlboro man, without the Marlboros. And the second of the four horsemen of the comment section. Doesn't make many videos, but he's a fixture in comment discussions. If you don't know who he is, maybe you don't really have an internet connection. Dick Coughlin? What's he doing on this list? Because a virtual arsonist burned his channel down, and we need to make sure everybody knows his new channel is Dick Dynasty 666, and because he's the guy who brought back the Fu Manchu beard. Dick hails from Fudge Pack upon Humber, Humberside. I'm not making that up. Jason. The man of a thousand voices. How does he do it? No one knows, but the characters on his Opinionville puppet series are so real it makes you forget Jason is crouched down behind them with his hand up there. You know. Hey, better you than me, pal. So go sub to Jason, but don't shake his hand. Finite Atticus. If he really is, we haven't seen his limits yet. He's got an interesting life story which he so articulately shares in his 14-part series, The Deconversion of Atticus Blake, and a bunch of other compelling videos coming out all the time, including that Pwnage video he shot from the waist down while eating a bag of chips. No one else can pull that kind of thing off. Anyway, he's a terrific guy who talks real good about stuff. Finn Larg. He's the guy I always think is from Sweden, but I think he's actually from Scotland? I think? Anyway, it doesn't matter because you can watch him from anywhere in the world. Down-to-earth guy with great skeptical explorations of religious claims. He was neck and neck with Capricious Black Box for the Nicest Guy in the World title. But things got ugly, they both really wanted to win, they started calling each other the most disgusting names. We had to cancel the competition, it's very sad. So Finlarg went home to Broken Wind, Aberdeenshire. Firefly 4F4. Now, you can't tell by looking at him, but he's another one of those Canadians. And besides that, he's a great guy. Doesn't do a lot of videos, but he's fun to listen to when he does. And his Lego building videos are cool. I appreciate a grown man who is not afraid to play with toys, as you might guess by some of my earlier ones. Fish Head Salad. What do you need to know that I haven't told you in other videos? Rule 1. Don't leave any unattended cocktails around this guy. He's like those wasted macaques on the funny animal videos who drink vacationers' daiquiris when they're not looking. Rule 2. Watch his videos. Great voice. Well-planned and edited content. Really sharp, focused stuff. Always enjoyable. And a good friend and extremely nice guy. Just don't engage him in conversation about any kind of modern technology. From, say, the cell phone onward, he starts to freak out. He wanted to go live off the grid like Ted Kaczynski, without all the bombing, of course, I think. But his wife told him to shut up and take out the trash, so that was that. Friendo. The man has game. He's articulate and fluent across many subjects in a skeptical, rational conversation. And he's in South Korea. Forget the heavily fortified border. He's the reason why the North hasn't overrun the 38th parallel. I'm serious. Gary Edwards. If you're going to take a precarious, uneducated stance on any issue in the philosophical milieu, Gary is the guy who will explain to you, as best you can understand, how it really works, and why you are ignorant, and quite possibly an idiot, all while cutting seamlessly between camera one, camera two, and a stuffed owl. Warning, schedule in some hardcore meditation immediately following one of his videos to keep his closing jingle from playing in your head the rest of the day. Damn you, Gary Edwards. You and everyone else in Jeffrey's Passage. Godless Glenn, he's broadcasting from a nice, well-kept family room somewhere down south. Great guy, passionate, thought-provoking, fun to listen to. And from what I heard, the inventor of the USB-powered fondue maker. In Modius we trust. He lay dormant for a time, waiting for the chosen one to come and read aloud the ancient runes on the door of his crypt. But now he's back, sort of. He made a very Christ-like reappearance a month or two ago, and he rattled off some big new content-producing promises. So I think he's going to make a triumphal surprise return with another great series like The Psychology of Creationism and Faith. For the moment, he's left us with a thrilling avatar thumbnail of his shoes. He's Seth Original, originally shouted out by Logic. If you make a stupid, ignorant, bigoted video of any kind, she will gladly run you through with the red-hot skewer of humorous ponage. In an accent I can't pinpoint, I want to believe she's making her content in the secret basement of a house in Riyadh or Tehran, risking everything to broadcast rationality to the world. Though she's probably shooting videos in a split-level ranch outside of Milwaukee, which would be fine because Milwaukee's fun, even though it's cold as ass in the winter. Jim the Evo. If you need a series on virulent diseases to be entertaining and insightful, this is the guy you want doing the presenting. Nice backlog of fascinating stuff to go through while you're waiting for his new content, because he's got a little side project going on called a dissertation. Jim, how long can something like this really take? A couple of weekends? Come on, put down the Xbox controller and give us the history of Argentine hemorrhagic fever. Oh, and speaking of, Jim is from Upper Bleeding, Sussex. John Smith. Like that's his real name. Anyway, John has a funny series satirizing like the whole Bible, and his breakneck speed of production makes me sick. It's the kind of serious production schedule where you can actually remember the last episode when the next one comes out. You see what I'm saying. His output stream isn't enough to scare Steve Shives or anything, but we're talking real world numbers here. So check out Skeptic's review over at the John Smith. Jolulipa. He's bilingual. That's someone who speaks in more than one language. This means he's simultaneously broadcasting reason toward North America and Latin America, a two-pronged attack. And he has really cool, almost vertical hair. Unless he was hanging upside down or touching a Tesla coil. King Grokoduck. He's the thorn in Ray Comfort's side. The other side. Bod to Bits has one side and he's got the other. But Casey is a student, possibly a prodigious whiz kid, who has threatened to reveal to us his age. This thing has gotten so built up now that we're half expecting to see a 16-year-old neurosurgeon walk through the door at the next big meetup. My guess, if we're starting a pool, 20. I say 20. Voting, but not yet drinking. Still, his kung fu is strong and his ponage is full-powered. KTB Black Adder. Wow, if we were going to reopen the nicest guy in the world competition, KTB would be in there, possibly dealing a deadly pile drive to Capricious Black Box or Finlar. It's a good thing we shut down that blood sport. This guy is well-spoken. You know, for some people, a British accent boosts their cred. He could drop his, and he'd still be a rock star. I think it's fake, anyway. They're all fake. All British accents are fake. Everybody knows that. But if you can do a good one, you're in. And his sounds like he's from Shitlingthorpe, Yorkshire. UK people, how am I doing so far? How many of those have I gotten right? Just checking in. Logicked. Now here's a guy whose wardrobe budget has to be twice his equipment budget. He's got to sweat through 4 or 5 of those suits a year. You want an idea of how hot hell would be if it were real? Film an entire hour of Ponich wearing all those layers, including the burqa, or stocking, face mask, whatever. His specialty is poning a lot of old Hovind and Pendleton classics from a command bunker somewhere located in Canada. This is the guy, for real, who spearheaded the 16-channel cross-promo video in January, which brought a lot of new viewers our way. He had the most subs of anyone at the time, so he stood to gain the least. Altruism? Or is there a hidden motive of pure evil? Who cares? Thanks, dude, for involving me in that. Much appreciated. A Holzmeroid. And I believe this is the correct pronunciation. Remember how Professor Anton is smarter than me? This guy is not just smarter than me, he's smarter than you. As you'll find out if you'll wander over to his other channel called Via Science, there he explains the unexplainable. Quantum mechanics. My guess is he's either a rocket scientist or a supervillain. A Holzmeroid is so smart he has to impair himself artificially just to function in society. That's why he wears the vice on his head. He's cursed by intelligence. His Mensa card itself had to be destroyed in order to prevent a global catastrophe, which is to say to keep Ian Juby from stealing it again. Looking Glass Universe. She's so next door neighbor that you almost forget she's teaching quantum mechanics. I want to see her and a Holzmeroid go for a full quantum mechanics face-off. It'd be like that time when Harry Potter and Hermione threw down and went wizard shit on each other. Well, I don't know if they ever did, but I wish they had. Anyway, I'm not going to guess on her hometown because she sounds way too nice to receive this kind of treatment. McNuts, too. He doesn't make many videos these days, but he's active everywhere. You can't miss him. That and the fact that he's a completely stand-up dude makes him the third of our four horsemen of the comment section. Look for him. He's out there. Probably right behind you. Magorian X. Making videos has not been high on this man's list, which makes him an asshole, because the few he's made are really good. Anyway, talk about well-spoken and presentable. Let me put it to you this way. This is the guy you'd want speaking for you if you just burned down your mother's house after falling asleep in the basement with a lit crack pipe in your hand. If there's any chance of smoothing things over with Mom, it's gonna be because Magorian X was there to advocate for you. Miss Robot Rock. She's anything but robotic. She's only in her early 20s, maybe, but puts across a fluent, reasonable, disarming point of view like she's been meditating in Taos for the last 3 years. And she can draw shit, so check out her shit. New Covenant Group. Very nice theists. They're on this list because they're really inclusive, like to have actual conversations. And I like them because anyone who's kicked Cy, Tenbruck, and Kate off their show gets the Bob Smeerfak seal of approval. No faith, no pain. Here's a chill guy. But he's got a great voice, 3D modeling skills. He's really thought-provoking. Check out his video titled Invocatus. And there's another one called Space Bug, Up Creationist You Know What. An interesting title, to be sure. Great video. He's also very smooth and relaxing. Picture it this way. He's so disarming that if he was in the same room as Ted Nugent and Jane Goodall, he'd have them casually swapping stories about their time in Africa. Anyway, I wish he'd make videos again, but I'm assuming he's very busy there in Sandy Balls, Hampshire. Wow, UK towns have a lot of balls. Number one son. Great guy. Funny. Good production values. Good radio voice. And he holds the patent for the zero-gravity paperweight. No, not really. But he does hold the patent on awesome, superb deconversion series. And another great series called Questions for Christians. And another new one called Worst Bible Characters. What will he do next? I don't know. But it's going to be good. Ozymandias Ramses II. This guy is diplomatic. During the Cold War, he served as liaison between Pol Pot and Mother Teresa. Or he would have. He's that good. Now, besides his own well-articulated videos, he's building more bridges during hangouts over at places like the New Covenant Channel. You know, I haven't seen a guy this calm since the Dalai Lama started taking beta blockers and painted his bedroom beige. Packard Sonic, inventor of the Braille loudspeaker. What else do you need to know? Okay, he's a fun guy who hosts a weekly show called Packard Pokes At, along with his guest hosts, Practical Magic 9 and Joe Unseen. I've been a guest host there myself once, and the only bad thing I could say about it was the donuts in the green room were moldy, and he said I needed to send him nude promotional photos, which was weird, so I did. Hey, I had a lot of fun there, and he and his crew have a really enjoyable show, so watch it on Friday nights. P.W. Swivel, effing bastard. Great scripts, great voice, great production, great animation, great big jackass, because he made a bunch of great videos, and then he went all sayonara, screw you guys, I'll see you later. Go watch all his videos and tell him to make more. And for crying out loud, he's a really nice guy too, except for being an effing non-video making anymore bastard. Paul C. Hartley, or Paul Chartley. Sir, please put this one to rest. Which is it? For the rest of you, he's the man who broke ground on one of the first chapter-by-chapter Bible satires, and was an inspiration for me to do mine. His Literally Genesis series is now published in book form. Go to his channel, check out the link. He's not making a lot of new videos right now, but the British guys have a lot of other stuff they have to do, like counting matchsticks, or cataloging his One Direction CD collection, perhaps. He grew up around Cox in Cornwall. Phil Hellenes. He's in the original pantheon of YouTube skeptics. When you buy the trading cards, his card is so rare and valuable that people are willing to trade some pretty heavy hitters to get one. I mean, I swapped 10 fish head salads and 2 living dinosaurs to get mine. Anyway, he made his last video somewhere back during the Great Age of Exploration? I don't know, but his video library is full of gems, so go watch them. Phil Hales from Twat. Shetland, not to be confused with Twat in Orkney. Practical Magic 9. She's a mother, she's a grandmother, she's a YouTuber, and all at the same time. A truly stand-up person who can wrangle a whole family and then regularly co-host the Packard Pokes At show on Friday nights. And of everyone on that show, she has the sexiest radio voice. Kills. I don't know what kind of ancient runes we need to recite to bring this guy back from the dead. Great production, great style, great voice, thought-provoking. What more can you ask for? Well, you could ask him to make more videos. But aside from that, well, okay, you could also ask him to make more videos. Robin Dupre Reed. She's the queen of the couch, the star of the sofa, the diva on the Davenport. Davenport, not too many people know that word anymore. Anyway, she's a gentle soul, no hint of sarcasm whatsoever, sending golden sunbeams of good wrong cue card. If you're a dumbass, she will jack your shit up. Several good series to choose from, all delivered directly from a sofa right in the middle of downtown Ponesville, USA. Check it out. Okay, former adult film star Steve Shives. Well, this was back in the day. Now he endorses his own line of sexual enhancement products called Phoenix Rising. Sounds a little new agey to me, but apparently it's helped a lot of the older guys. But he starred in a lot of pornos. You remember Huge and Huger? He was in that. He was huge. The other guy was huger. And Apollo Threesome, which was a ripoff, because the windows of the lunar module steamed up as they made re-entry, and you couldn't see anything. Must have been made for cable. He also did a period piece on location in his hometown called The Sharpsburg Shooter. In that one, they fought the entire Revolutionary War naked. It was totally predictable, though. The British still got fucked. But let's talk about the Steve Shives of today. Here's a guy I've known for quite a while on YouTube who's been a good friend and supporter of the Bob Smeerfak Studios. This is the guy I gave a shout out to when I had a couple hundred more subscribers than him, and he graciously acted as though it did his channel some good. He's a top-notch guy. He has a gift for entertaining and commentary. And he's the hardest working man on YouTube. But hard is relative when you've got those kinds of chops. He's putting out 5-6 videos a week, but he's not even found his stride yet. He's pacing himself. He wasn't pacing himself in that porno about the two competitive suburban couples trying to one-up each other in the sack called Keeping It Up with the Joneses. But anyway. Suicide for celluloid. He knows enough philosophy to stop a charging moose in the rut. That takes a lot of philosophy, in case you didn't know. If there was a philosophy drinking game where a missed answer meant a shot of bourbon, you might as well start an IV while he sits there stone cold sober. Except philosophy is kind of a drinking game anyway, right? In which case he's most likely perpetually wasted. That's just the truth though. You know, all the philosophers drink heavily. at least the good ones, Cheeky Vimto, Messianic Manic, Gary Edwards, guys like that, their entire disposable income goes to booze. Talking primate. An analogy. If YouTube is the Higgs field, Dana is like virtual particles. He pops in and out of existence. Right now, the Higgs field appears to be quiet with one recent uptick, but a great voice, good sense of humor, makes parody songs. My favorite is Blame It On Your Boss Jehovah. Needs to make some new videos because I said so. The faith check. Where is he? He's past the point of being dormant. He's in a cryogenic freeze. Somebody needs to get over there and thaw him out. Super guy, good voice to have out there in the mix. So make more videos. The felt be gone. He's the fourth horseman of the comments section. So look, I don't exactly know why, and they have no idea, but there's these four guys, Dahey Dublin, Deep Ashtray, McNuts 2, and The Felt Be Gone, who hold this sort of a sagely status for me. Whenever they comment on a video, any video, if I see it, I'm like, oh, what did he have to say? Let's take a look here. Ooh, that was brilliant. I don't know, they feel like big brothers. They seem like statesmen. They're probably also like, what are you, some kind of platonic stalker? Well, yes. Yes, I am. Anyway, anyone who doesn't treat these guys well can kiss my butt. If you've got to be a troll to someone, take it out on fish head salad. Wake up his wife with a telephone call at 2 a.m. That's very effective. The global atheism.
Well, hello there.
He's got a lovely accent, doesn't he? But everyone from cock intake Staffordshire is blessed with superior vocal cords, among other things. He's doing an interactive series right now on morality. It's great stuff. Top-notch guy. Driving force behind the invention of the transparent toaster. The living dinosaur. Oh yeah. He is what 3 billion years of evolution leads to. A quadrillion well-oiled synapses. You know how many that is? That's the number of synapses in the brain of a 3-year-old child. Sorry, I couldn't resist. And speaking of well-oiled, I can't reveal too much for fear of litigation, but he has admitted himself that the story of the two hairless chihuahuas and the lubricant is true. Okay, enough. Here's the real truth. This is the guy who gave me my second shout-out, which drove in about 800 subs in 2 days. Sort of like one of those Ice Age man-made mammoth stampedes where they drive them all over a cliff and they fall into a huge pile. Some of you guys were in that pile. Thank you. And thank TLD. He's been a great friend to the channel and very supportive. He's a first-rate Welshman, and they're all very proud of him back in his hometown of Three Cocks, Breconshire. A lot of cocks in the UK, too. I'm not sure what this naming convention is all about. Anyway, moving on. The Messianic Manic. He drinks heavily. We already know that. He's a philosopher. What you may not know is where he got that one black hat. You know the one. Oh, I'm just going to tell you. He killed an Amish guy. Cold blood, no reason. But he did it with respect for the man's beliefs. He used a knife. And he made his getaway on a horse. Now he's built a great YouTube channel that's slowly eating William Lane Craig's soul. Very smart. Edgy. Master of the under 3-minute video. A lost art. The Way of the Pasta. Definitely from down under, as he used to be called, the Atheist Aussie. And I think he's from the town of Cockwash, South Australia. But he sounds like he's spent quite a bit of time in Humpybong, Queensland. He's a funny man, producing content straight out of a backyard tool shed / production studio. Here's a fun fact. He's ranked number one in Australia's most popular extreme sport. Being bitten or stung by every venomous animal indigenous to the continent. He's only missing the box jellyfish and the funnel web spider. Go for it, dude. Thunderfoot. Some people love him. Some people hate him. Some people love to hate him. Some people hate to love him, but they just can't stop watching him. He's the guy who made maybe the most popular creationist takedown series on YouTube. He's also the guy who took on Rebecca Watson at Madison Square Garden in a 12-round slugfest. I think it's still in round 6.
You see this guy? This guy's in love with you. Yes, I'm in love. Who looks at you the way I do?
All I know is the couple of times I've spoken with him in comments, he's been very supportive of the Bob's Notes series. And maybe he doesn't know this, but the first time he favorited an episode, it brought in 500 subs in a couple of days. And every time after that, it drove in thousands of views. Holy shit. Thanks, dude. I really appreciated that. The only thing I could offer you is don't rely on your right cross. Throw combos and aim for the pancreas. But don't underestimate her. She just started that Dolph Lundgren training regimen, Rocky IV. Moving on. Truth Search. Who is this man? You may know him from the terrific series Excavating the Empty Tomb. He's got my vote for the most talented person we know of in the YouTube skeptic circles. He's a pro at everything he touches. The crime of the 21st century is that he's also a stupefyingly professional guitarist who, as far as I know, is not being paid to play the guitar. If a well-known rock band from the 70s or 80s lost their lead guitarist during a tour, this man could seriously learn their catalog over a weekend and go on a road. Where he came by this skill, we do not know. And maybe we don't want to know. And this is the guy who grew a beard just to show ZZ Top what facial hair was really like, and then shaved it off. True story, mostly. Veneloid. He's a nice, bright young man in the process of getting a higher education, which could mean a lot of beer and toga parties. Except he looks like the kind of kid who has his act together. He looks so responsible that if he were Otter and Animal House, he would turn down Dean Wormer's wife because it's the right thing to do. And he probably has no idea what I'm talking about. Anyway, great channel, good guy. Wise Apple. Here we have a young lady with some serious comic mojo. She's obviously done some work on the stage and or on camera because her videos are put together. She has Mondo presence. Anyway, I'm working on an episode of another series I do, and it is my hope that she'll respond favorably if I beg her to do some voice acting for me. You can't see me, but I'm on my knees right now. Really, I'm flat on my ass. But what do you say? You'd have a masseuse in your own trailer. Which is to say, I know a guy named Larry who gives a decent back rub and drives a Winnebago. Think it over. Wildwood Claire won. She single-handedly brought the phrase soggy bottom out of the gutters and back into your coffee, where it belongs. And she gave me one of my first shout-outs. She knows a lot about geology, soccer, and ponage. She could field strip an INgrooves and put him back together in under 90 seconds, in the dark. Without the use of her hands. You never want to touch one of those directly anyway. Whatever, I just like hearing her say...
Sugar britches.
Xandar's meteor. He has become much like Halley's Comet. He swoops in once every 76 years. This is the guy who favorited my first video, which brought in my first sub, Manila Barista. Then he gave me my first shout-out. I went to 100 subs and I thought I'd made it. I was checking the real estate listings for a bigger place to accommodate my inflating ego. This guy is terrific. I'll always be his biggest fan. If I ever find out someone else is a bigger fan than me, I'm gonna kill them because I can't let that happen. Okay, forget about all of that. I'm calling out Xandar's Meteor to make a new video. If you don't make a new video, I'm gonna kill Fish Head Salad. It's up to you. Zoroaster. All hail the big spongy Mr. Microphone. And if you don't know what that means, go over there and get yourself some Zoroaster. He's got great stuff on the origin of the New Testament. He has New Testament biblical history pouring out every opening in his body. Yeah, that's right. This guy knows what color underwear Emperor Constantine wore to the Nicene Council in 325 AD. I'm just saying, do not face off with this guy over the details of the Marcion canon. He will bury you, using little more than his mind, a whiteboard, and a spongy yellow microphone. I'm serious. Yes, I'm Sandwich. Who's she? Well, she holds the record for the most consecutive hours of Zelda played on a vintage Dreamcast while vaping controlled pharmaceuticals. That's not true, I think. But she's the one who helped inspire me to make the most interesting creationist in the world videos. Anyway, she started a collection of her own very thoughtful videos, and then the sun rose and she had to get back in her coffin. I don't know, she hasn't made anything in over a year. Well, I'm knocking on your sarcophagus. Hello? It's okay, I can be mean to her. She's a good friend. That's what friends do for each other. Oh, and finally, please, please go visit these other channels that I didn't have time to talk about in this video. So what's coming up next? I've threatened to make another episode of your Bible on psychotherapy as soon as I can work up the nerve to try to write it. It's going to be about Samson. You know, the guy who kicked major ass until he cut his hair. Sort of like Michael Bolton, but a little different. Probably before that will be another installment of the Bible interviews. And we're going to get all up in Mary Magdalene's head. But first, a new Bob's Notes, coming as soon as I can manage it. Anyway, thanks for watching. Tell all your friends. Now go on, get out of here.